This is Mercury Redstone 1, MR-1, ready for launch at Cape Canaveral, Florida. Launch complex number 5. The spacecraft is a production line version. This spacecraft is destined to make a successful flight over a ballistic flight path. It will not carry man, but will help pave the way for man in space.
I was always interested in the space program, in aviation, in airplanes and spaceships and science and technology. When I was a kid, I didn't think it was a reality to me. My first public library card and the first book I ever checked out of the library was in third grade, and the book was called Project Mercury. I read the book from cover to cover, wrote a book report on it. But again, I never thought it was possible until many, many years later.
So, you want to be an astronaut? If you have what it takes, we want you up here.
NASA's Professional Astronaut Corps works as a team to train and to fly for the benefit of all humankind and to provide crew perspective for all of human space exploration. We serve our country and our planet by testing, developing, investigating, and flying. Our decisions today ensure mission success and crew safety for some of the most audacious missions humans have ever undertaken, to the moon and beyond. If this sounds like you, then join our team.
The process to become an astronaut was a long one. I applied, and it took about a year and a half for NASA to down select from the initial 3,000 applicants, in my case, to around 19. And of course, being a naval officer, a naval aviator, I had to apply to the Navy first, get past the Navy board before my name was ever sent down to NASA. And on the day that I received the phone call, it was close to April Fool's. I thought it might have been some of my buddies playing a trick on me. But when I got the phone call and the gentleman on the other end of the line said, well, congratulations, you've been selected. We want you to come down here to Houston and join the astronaut corps. I would try to be as calm and collected as I possibly could. I replied by, yes, sir, thank you very much. I'm so happy. I look forward to seeing you. But when I put the phone down, I just said, yes! And it truly was a life-changing phone call, a life-changing event. Everything has been so different, so unlike my life prior to becoming an astronaut. So the young people, I always say that you will encounter obstacles. That's life. Everybody encounters obstacles. But if you face those obstacles and you will never give up, then you will overcome them and you're likely to achieve whatever your goal happens to be.